Dear letter X, you are quintessential divinity and hope to black cause. A symbol of consciousness and free will oozing from terrible recollections of unexpected raids in African souls, our souls. You are beacon of love and fire to our fallen brethren, reduced to nothing but desolate shells of themselves. Vistas of freedom cutting across suns and moons and lands of the spirit. You are masses of fabled rebels who knew courage by its name and passion by its flame. But letter X, wherever you are, we still have no idea of your color. That you are the compelling one-dimensional hue spectrum decorating mothers with life. You are first and third heavens, triple dark moon goddess in the heart of Azania and Kemet. You are irrefutable tongues that exude and speak revolution. Stories of forced unfamiliar residences underneath seas and in coastal vessels, and thus you remain unforgettable memories. You are acoustic sounds in mantras, percussions in reminiscence, the light that shines black and the ink that is life. Songs by Igbos marching ashore, begging waters to swallow them back to their ancestors. You are moors that even death cannot defeat. The bloody storms that resurrected men and women wearing shields and rainbows of flesh. You are gaps wrapped around loins of African stories too nimble to break. You are Kwame, Batman, Rosa and Winnie, impetus that turned tears into desert. You are prayers in mountains and mountains of prayers, reincarnation of infants who found their ways back to their mother's wombs and saw you a god of life and waters, your healing and built rivers of five fingers, your blessings in greens, consonants dancing in syllables too black for nasals too pronounced. And I speak of you, I speak of you as black history in Kenya has and nappy afros cracking skulls of humans who owned humans. But letter X, they still don't know who you are. And I guess they would never do.